height. And what that's doing is the sap is all the roots of the tree. As it warms up in the spring, that sap is going up the tree to fill all the buds to make leaves for the summer. When it gets cold at night, it comes down out of the tree so it doesn't freeze, and that's where we get our sap from. Now what we use here, one of these, this is called a spile. So you simply drill a small hole in the tree, tap this in with a hammer, put a bucket and lid on it like these ones, and then on those warm days, cold nights, you should fill the pails once a day. And then we go around and we collect it all, and it goes into that building on my right where our evaporator is. And that's what we use to make all the maple syrup. So with an evaporator, you have a fire on, which is boiling the sap from the tree, evaporating all the water as steam, and leaving the sugar behind. Because the sap that's coming out of the tree is 98% water and only 2% sugar. Maple syrup is 66% sugar. So all we do is boil it. We never add any sugars or flavors. It's just simply that sap boiled down to get rid of all that water. To do that though, it generally takes us about 40 liters of sap to make 1 liter of maple syrup. And about 80 liters of sap to make 1 liter of taffy for taffy on the snow. It's twice as thick before we can pour it out and have that delicious treat. So. You'll see on the wall behind me here, we have some pails hanging up. We invite our guests to give us a hand to collect some of that sap so that we can process it into more delicious syrup. There's a bunch of trails out behind us here. You're more than welcome to walk around. Everything close to the camp is collected a lot. So if you go further back and be more adventurous, you should find some. It's not running real strong today, so we need to...